The casket carrying the body of the fallen Supreme Court Justice Stella Arach Amoko arrived at Parliament at 1 p.m., where it was received by the Speaker of Parliament, Anita Among. The body was then laid in state, where members of Parliament and other people gathered for public viewing and signing in the condolence book. At 2 p.m., the special sitting started and the casket was moved to the Parliament chambers, and different dignitaries led by the Speaker laid wreaths in respect of the fallen icon of justice. While moving the motion to pay tribute to Justice Stella Arach Amoko, the Prime Minister Robinah Nabbanja said the late had a distinguished and faultless career serving in the public service, the judiciary and the East African community.
Recognizing that the Honorable Lady Justice Stella Arach Amoko was an extraordinary jurist and an icon of justice who was instrumental in mainstreaming alternative dispute resolution mechanisms in the judiciary and has been a mentor to judicial officers and advocates whose legal mind and dedication have left an indelible mark on the judiciary.
In her tribute, the Speaker of Parliament, Anita Among, eulogized the deceased judge as a great advisor who was loving and caring to everyone. She added that Justice Amoko was a distinguished and exemplary judge who was very humane and approachable.
When you look at the judicial officers are bound by common values. That is transparency, accountability, objectivity, and honesty. And that's what Honorable Arach had, and that's what the judicial officers out there, all the judicial officers out there stand for.
MPs also spoke on the legacy of the late member of the Supreme Bench, whom they defined as a dignified jurist.
Justice, who believed in fairness, accountability, transparency, and constitutionalism. It is my aggregate belief that an independent judiciary is what she ambitioned and aspired to when she sought to practice law and later adjudicate justice in Uganda.
That was in Arua High Court. And as a paralegal, of course, after seeing a judge, you'll all want to crowd and move away from her. And she said, no, come to me. And she held my hand. I went with her to the office.
She has gone at the time when we really needed mentorship to the girl child. In Greater Nebi, it is a big challenge.
If we are set, talking about standards, she sets the gold standard in the judiciary.
The Shema South MP, Professor Elijah Mshemeza, moved to amend the motion to urge government to increase resources for judiciary to perform their duties well, and it was supported by several legislators. The body of the fallen Supreme Court judge will spend a night lying in state until tomorrow morning, and thereafter it will leave the parliamentary building for her final send-off. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.